Gordon Parks, at age 88, has had a prolific career as a world-famous photographer for Life magazine, as a best-selling novelist, as the first black director of a Hollywood studio film, and as a composer and poet and pianist. He is most famous for his poignant pictures of racism and poverty, and in film for directing the 1970s classic Shaft. He is now the subject of an HBO documentary called Half Past Autumn, The Life and Works of Gordon Parks, which tells the whole story of an artist's diverse career in every medium, from film to music to ballet. Now, why do we call this Half Past Autumn?
Half Past Autumn?
Yeah, why is that the title of this documentary?
Well, I think that I've associated my lifetime with seasons of the year.
Yes.
And I think I naturally start off with spring.
Yes.
Summer.
Fall.
Fall. Autumn.
Yeah.
Winter. And at this point, 88, I'm
in fall.
Yes,
you're a half past autumn.
Half past autumn.
I mean, there's no need to rush into winter unless you have to.
Don't rush into it. You know? I don't expect winter to come for a long time.
All right, take a look at this. This is a clip from a documentary about him talking about
Gordon Parks, a figurehead in the civil rights movement in the 1940s through to the 1970s. Born in 1912 to vegetable farmers. He attended segregated schools all his life. He didn't seek higher education, as teachers actively discouraged African Americans from doing so. He wasn't considered anything special by his teachers. After finishing school, and after his mother's death at age 14, he left home, taking any job he could, until he made enough money to buy his first camera at 25.
So I got to Seattle, Washington. I went to a pawn shop. I only had little money. I think I had about $10. And I saw this Voigtlander Brilliant in the window. It was secondhand. And I went and asked for how much I could get it for. He said, well, $12. I said, well, I don't have $12. I got about $10. He said, well, I'll sell it to you for $7.50. I said, okay, and I bought it.
It wasn't until famed boxer Joe Louis's wife, Marva Louis, saw Gordon's fashion photography and encouraged him to move to the city. In 1948, he moved to Harlem, where a photograph he took of a gang leader caught the attention of Life magazine, who hired him as a permanent staff member. He worked there for 20 years. Parks documented his world through photography. He told a story of segregation.
Still fight for our children's needs are the same as those of your children. We too are America. America is us. It gave us the only life we know, so we must share in its survival. Look at us. Listen to us. Try to understand us. Our appeal is urgent. There is yet a chance for all of us to live in peace beneath these restless skies.
A story of poverty. Allocated entrances, blue-collar jobs, a world of hate. And of liberation. Here comes Ali. You can see him there, very calm. If you saw the other Gordon met Muhammad Ali in Miami in 1966, in the hopes that Parks could redeem Ali's reputation following his conscientious objection to the Vietnam War, and in being accused of anti-white sentiments. Parks aimed to show Ali's charm, his human side, his soothing presence. Gordon was a pioneer for documentative photography. His work towards bringing the condition of the black ethnic community to the public domain proves the historical importance for capturing points in time that would have otherwise gone unseen. He went on to direct the American action film Shaft, introducing the black action hero into mainstream Hollywood, which led to being credited as a co-founder of the blaxploitation subgenre, paving the way for future films and black actors. So, what has changed today?
LAPD tweeting that they hear the protesters' pain and their anger, and so did we as we marched alongside them tonight. People of all races, many of them so angry they were near tears as they protested the death of George Floyd.
The world has seen a great deal of change, both in the consumption of media and how people use it. The Black Lives Matter movement is a testament to this, the passing of George Floyd in 2020 added fuel to the fire of the movement against racial injustice. People took to the streets. They took to social media. The world watched these events unfold. This inspired change. But had this exposure never happened, would George have been another name amongst the hundreds that weren't given justice? The spotlight on minorities has transcended the world of photography. We see inklings of Gordon's work in the mainstream music. From Childish Gambino, Beyonce.
Just say his name and I promise Kendrick that Lamar. Candy man, because it's all in your eyes. Most of y'all tell lies. Most of y'all don't fade. Most of y'all been advised. Last LP I tried to lift the black goddess.
Photography brings attention to the unseen. Photography exposes these subjects and keeps them alive. There are individuals who see Gordon Parks as their inspiration for doing so. Like Volandes, a successful Detroit-based photographer who strives on capturing what life is really like in his city.
Gordon Parks is my favorite and, in my opinion, the best photographer to ever touch a camera. This impact that Gordon Parks and who he is to the African-American photographer is what means so much to me.
Or Mike Gray, an artist keen on merging history with the modern perception on African-American society. Gordon didn't enjoy taking photographs of crime, suffering, and oppression. But he understood the importance of what he did, and more importantly, what it could become. Media can evolve. It's like a web of images that grows larger and larger, forever fluctuating. The spotlight on issues minorities from all different races and backgrounds face has never been brighter. We have those who are brave enough in the past to be thanked. But don't ever forget who it was behind the lens.